Jupiter, the king of our solar system, is home to a vast and diverse collection of moons. These moons range in size from small asteroid-like bodies to Ganymede, the largest moon in our solar system. Among these celestial dancers is Elara, a small icy moon that orbits Jupiter at a great distance. Elara is a member of the Himalia Group, a family of moons that share similar orbits and are thought to have a common origin. Despite its small size, Elara holds clues to the formation and evolution of Jupiter's moon system. In the early 20th century, the study of our solar system was undergoing a renaissance. Astronomers, armed with increasingly powerful telescopes, were making groundbreaking discoveries that expanded our understanding of the planets and their moons. Charles Dillon Perrine, an ambitious astronomer at the Lick Observatory, found himself at the forefront of this exciting era. Perrine was particularly interested in Jupiter, the largest planet in our solar system. He spent countless nights peering through the observatory's telescope, meticulously observing Jupiter and its surroundings. On January 5th, 1905, Perrine's patience and dedication were rewarded. While examining photographic plates he had taken of Jupiter, Perrine noticed a faint object near the gas giant. This object, too faint to be seen with the naked eye, appeared as a small dot on the photographic plate. Intrigued, Perrine continued his observations over the following nights. To Perrine's excitement, the object's position relative to Jupiter was changing, indicating that it was indeed a moon orbiting the giant planet. Perrine had discovered a new moon of Jupiter, a testament to the power of careful observation and the ever-evolving nature of scientific discovery. Elara, like many of Jupiter's outer moons, is a small and enigmatic world. Its estimated diameter is only about 80 kilometers or 50 miles, making it one of the smaller moons in the Jovian system. From Earth, Elara appears as a faint point of light, even through the most powerful telescopes. However, despite its diminutive size and distance, astronomers have been able to glean some information about Elara's physical characteristics. Based on its brightness and spectral analysis, scientists believe that Elara is composed primarily of water ice and rocky material. Its surface is likely heavily cratered, bearing the scars of billions of years of impacts from asteroids and comets. The moon's dark surface, with an albedo or reflectivity of only about 0.04, suggests the presence of organic compounds mixed with the ice and rock. Section 4. Elara's cosmic dance, orbit, and rotation. Elara is a distant moon of Jupiter, orbiting at an average distance of about 11.7 million kilometers, or 7.3 million miles. This places Elara well beyond the orbits of Jupiter's four largest moons, Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto, which are known as the Galilean moons. Elara's orbit is eccentric, meaning that its distance from Jupiter varies throughout its orbit. At its closest point, Elara comes within about 11 million kilometers of Jupiter, while at its farthest, it is over 12 million kilometers away. Elara takes approximately 259 Earth days to complete one orbit around Jupiter. Its orbital period is similar to that of other members of the Himalaya group, suggesting that these moons may have formed together. Elara's rotation period, the time it takes to spin once on its axis, is unknown. However, astronomers believe that it is likely tidally locked to Jupiter, meaning that it always shows the same face to the planet, just as our moon does to Earth. Section 5, Elara's place in the Jovian court, the Himalaya group. Elara is a member of the Himalaya group, a family of prograde irregular satellites of Jupiter. The group is named after its largest member, Himalaya, which has a diameter of about 170 kilometers. Other members include Leda, Lysithia, and S2000J11. These moons are thought to be remnants of a larger body captured by Jupiter's gravity. They provide insights into the formation and evolution of Jupiter's moon system. Their irregular orbits suggest they were captured from the solar nebula. Studying these moons helps us understand how planets acquire and retain their moons. Section 6. Elara's future, unlocking the secrets of a distant moon. Despite decades of observations, Elara remains largely unexplored. Its small size and distance make it challenging to study. Future missions with advanced instruments could provide a closer look. A flyby mission like NASA's Juno would capture detailed images. High-resolution cameras could reveal Elara's surface and composition. Measuring Elara's mass and density would help understand its structure. A dedicated mission like Europa Clipper could study the Himalaya group. Orbiting these moons allows for long-term study. Investigating geology and potential water ice could enhance our understanding.